Hi there. Did you enjoy the previous video? Excited about the possibilities of the block editor? Surprised by the large number of blocks that are available? Great! So far, we focused on adding blocks, and we've deleted one as well. Adding and deleting are both things you need to be able to do. In this screencast, I'm going to explain two more actions: moving blocks and transforming blocks. Easy? Yes. Fast? Yes. Clear? Yes. So, what are we waiting for? Let's scroll down our post one more time. Let's see whether there are things that can be improved. Maybe this is not the right place for the quote, because it's about something Yoast says in the video. I think it makes more sense to move it towards the video block. How do I do this? If I click on the pull quote block, I see an option in the left corner with arrows pointing up and down. I can use these arrows to move the block up or down. So I move it up and put it right below the video. Another way to move your block is by hovering your mouse cursor to the dots in the middle. Then you'll see this little hand appear. If you click and hold the mouse button, you can move the block around. You have to move the block a little towards the middle to see these blue lines appear. Now, all you have to do is drag your block to the right place, so the right blue line, and release your mouse button to drop it there. So, now you know how to move a single block. But you can also move more blocks at once. Take the blocks that are now below the pull quote. There's four of them: a heading, a paragraph, a list, and a button. Now, what I'm going to do is select them all. Click the first of the four blocks, then press the Shift key on the keyboard, and then I click the last block I want to include in this group, and that's the button. My selection of four blocks is now completely blue, and now I can move them all at once by clicking the upward or downward pointing arrow. As soon as you click somewhere else, the selection is deselected. Selecting blocks is related to grouping blocks, but it's not the same. We'll come back to grouping in the next screencast. The second part of this screencast is about transforming blocks. Let's go back to the pull quote block. I've been staring at it for a while now, and I realize that I'm not completely satisfied with how it looks. It's too big and too bold. But you know what? The block editor gives me the option to transform blocks. It's not the same as editing. If you edit, you adjust the options for that specific block type. And transforming is about changing one block type into another with just one click. Not all blocks can be transformed, but still a lot of them can. The transform options are different per block type. Let's see what options there are for the pull quote block. The first button in the toolbar shows the icon of the pull quote. If I click it, I see that I can change the style or transform the block to a group or a quote. We will look at how to change styles later. For now, let's see what happens if I change the block type into a quote. Yes, this looks better. The quote is more discreet now, which is what I wanted. If I change my mind, I can always transform it back into a pull quote by doing the same thing. I click the transform button in the toolbar. Apparently, the quote block has more options to choose from. As I've said before, the options are different for each block type. Anyways, that's it for this video. You now know how to move and transform blocks. In the next video, we'll explore two other awesome functionalities: grouping and reusing blocks.